Joshua, how are you guys as a group dealing with the news about Kosta from yesterday? That finally, there's a, you know, not closure is not the right word, but I mean, you found out a teammate has passed. I mean, how have y'all dealt with that?
That's tough news, and guys are dealing with it in different ways. The best thing that we've done is that we're a really close group this year, and so we're just having communication with each other. Guys are picking each other up. Kosta was probably one of the most hardworking guys I knew, and for a guy who was a fifth-year walk-on, who probably knew he wasn't going to play any snaps this year, he was always getting extra work after practice. You know, he was a funny guy. He was really lighthearted. He was goofy. Always had a smile on his face. So, you know, to hear news like that, it was really tragic. But we're praying for his family, and we know that he's in a better place now.
Do you remember him ever complaining about having any kind of problems with his head, et cetera, in the last several months?
I don't know anything about that. I just know that our training staff is really, really good, and so if there were any issues, I know they handled it.
Do guys ever talk about that? I mean, we know it's no secret that with football, concussions are an issue. Do guys ever share in the locker room, hey, I'm feeling weird, or, you know, is that something guys talk about? You're all going through it.
Yeah, I mean, if guys have any issues, they just take it to our training staff, and I know that they do the best that they can to handle any situations.
Hey, Joshua, you've been a scholarship player. What's it like for the guys who are walk-ons? They kind of take a beating, it seems like, without getting some of the benefits that you guys have.
Yeah, we reward those guys extremely, and we enjoy having them, and they're a part of the family just like anybody else. And a lot of times you'll see that those guys, they had to earn the respect of their teammates, so they get treated better than scholarship guys at times just because of the work that they put in, how invested they are into the team. You know, a couple of my best friends on this team are walk-ons, Craig Fada and Joe Berger, and those guys are some of the most hardworking guys on the squad. So it just shows that it doesn't matter how you get here, the fact that you're here and the fact that you work hard, you can gain respect and love and all that from your teammates.
You guys have been through a lot of stuff this year, you know, from the Braxton injury to Noah Spence, and then, you know, this last week, you know, JT gets hurt and the tragic situation with Kosta. What is it about this team that lets you feel like, you know, we're going to come out right on the other end? I mean, what is it about this team that you've been able to handle all that stuff and makes you confident that you can handle this latest dose of
games here? We're battle tested, obviously, through all the adversity that we've had. But I think the biggest thing is how we took to our training from this offseason and how we respond to those situations. And the big thing for us was you'll be put in situations that are tough. You'll face adversity, obviously, as a football player, but how you respond is what's important. And so being through all the leadership training and spending all that time that we put into how to respond, I think that we've done a great job. Obviously, we've got another hurdle that we're facing right now, but everybody keeps saying JT went down and Cardale, this, Cardale, that, but I mean, he's a scholarship player. Dude's got a ridiculous arm. He spent a lot of time working. He was our number two guy in the spring, so obviously he's very capable. People had their reservations about JT coming into the season. Obviously you saw what he did. So you never know, and I got a lot of faith in our guys and the preparation and the training that we have that we'll be able to respond.
When you say ridiculous arm, how?
I mean just like a like Coach Meyer said, he has a cannon for an arm. Like, that's not a joke. He'll be on a knee and throw the ball 60 yards on a rope, like that kind of stuff. I mean, it's amazing to see.
The closeness of this team, do you feel like any of it started back in Indianapolis a year ago, and what kind of happened at the end of the season last year?
I think a lot of it started this past offseason, this winter, going through mat drills and all the fourth quarter training and the stuff that we did. That brought us tighter together, because all of that was for the chance to get back here and to be able to achieve our goal of winning a championship. You know, we had the videos that kind of showed us, you know, missteps from the Big Ten championship, and then we come out here and our coaches are grinding us, and we still got the Chase banner up from last year, the Chase that we never finished. And so I think that's where it came from, was really last offseason, guys just pulling together and saying that we've got unfinished business a little bit from last year, but we've got goals that we're trying to achieve. We're trying to send the seniors out right.